Okay guys, so today we are going to show you how you can design a beautiful full-width hamburger menu that looks super modern and trendy. So we are going to build two different templates, and the first one will look something like this, with very eye-catching menu items, and when you hover on top of each of these, it will change the background image. And the second template is this one here, and when you hover on top of each menu items, they will reveal a lovely image with a special effect. Now all of these obviously are fully customizable based on your own preferences. Okay, so for this project we are going to use a few of the plus add-ons widget along with Nexter Builder to create our menu section. My name is Dave from the plus add-ons for Elementor. Now don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel as we upload new Elementor videos each week, which will make you an Elementor master in no time. And also please feel free to share with your Facebook communities so that your friends can learn more about Elementor as well. Very good. So let's get started. Okay, so the very first step is to take care of our header section. So for this, we're going to use Nexter Builder and we're going to create a new template. So add new, and from here, let's give it a title. So maybe menu, and we need to select what type of layout this is. So this is a section. This is a header. We're going to display this on the whole website. So here we can select entire website and then publish. And now we can edit with Elementor. So let's create our structure. So maybe three different columns here. So we could have this one maybe at 33%. There you go. This one could be roughly 50%, and whatever's left for our hamburger menu. So let's go to 50% for this. Okay. So we're going to insert our logo right here. So for this, we're going to select an image, drag and drop. Let's select our image. So we uploaded logo. We can select this one here, insert media. Very good. And now we're going to insert a menu section here. So menu, and we're going to select our own widget here from the plus add-on navigation menu. Let's drag and drop it here. And now we need to select our type of menu. So this is a default horizontal. And now let's select our menu. So we created one already. So this one is main navigation and everything else can remain the same. And now we're going to add our hamburger menu here, which is part of the pop-up builder. So pop-up and drag and drop, which is a fantastic widget as we shall soon demonstrate. Very, very powerful indeed. And now there are a few different options we need to take care of. So here, as you can see, the first one is the type of pop-up: slide, model pop-up, reveal content, or corner box. In our case here, it will be slide. And which direction do you want to open it? Left, right, top, or bottom? In our case, we're going to select bottom, but feel free to select any other options based on your own preferences. Now, the open width, obviously, we want this to take the full width. So this is very important here to put 100%. Don't forget to select the percent here. And we have the content type, which is a template. So we will create the template in a few minutes. So this is the option we need to select. And here we will be able to select the template once we have it created. Okay, we can link it back to this feature. Now at the moment, it looks like a call to action button. And the reason is because we selected call to action here. So what we need is to select another one. This will be an icon. And then we can select the type of icon. As you can see, you can select among a few different styles. The one we're interested in today is style number 2. As you can see, it looks like a hamburger menu now. And now we can customize our button here and the content that will be displayed. So we can go to style. And here, make sure that the padding is set to 0. So we can link this and set everything to 0. So basically, we don't want any gap once we display the menu here when we open the template. And then we can change the color of our button here as well. So for this, we go to toggle icon hamburger and let's add a color. Okay, so let's select maybe whichever color you want. You could be red or whatever. So let's keep it simple. Let's go with black. And then the icon color itself can be changed as well to get more contrast. And as you can see, now it looks just about perfect. Okay, so we are almost done now. So let's go back to the content now and let's have a quick look. So we have the extra options here. So we have the fixed toggle button here, and also all these display options. This is more oriented for pop-up windows, and we have a dedicated video about this. So if you want to have a quick look as well how to use these for pop-up windows, we'll leave a link in the description below. Okay, so let's go ahead with our step number two. Now, let's create the template that we can link to this hamburger menu. And for this, let's go back to our WordPress dashboard. So let's have a quick look at our project this far. So as you can see, we have a menu section here. If you click on it, it will open up at the bottom, but there is nothing here. So this is our next step, is to create the template that will go inside this section, okay? And for this, we're going to use Elementor. So we go to templates here. Okay, so let's click on this. And now let's add a new one. So from here, we're going to select page. Let's give it a name. So perhaps hamburger template one. And let's create a template. So clearly for this template, we don't need any header or footer section. So for this, we're going to go to settings. And in the page layout, select Elementor canvas. And let's add our section now. So let's add a structure of one column only. Now we're going to set this as full width, no gap. The height will be minimum height of 100% of the vertical height. So let's set this to 100. The column position middle, and then vertical align will select top, and the overflow will be default. And now we can insert our widget. So for this, we're going to use one of our own widgets, which is called animated service boxes. Again, this is from the Plus add-ons. So what does that one do exactly? Let me show you from our website. So if you scroll down the page, there is an example here similar to what we're going to build here. So as you can see, we have a few different images. And if you hover on top of any of those menu section here, it will show a different image. So this is what we're going to reproduce now. So basically from here, we're going to select portfolio, style 2. And now we can add our menu items. So they are right here. So we can add as many as we want. So let's add maybe four of them, okay? So let's create the first one. So let's call this one home, just like this. And now we can link the image that will display in the background once you hover on top of it. So let's scroll down our options here. So let's select an image. So we uploaded a few already. Just make sure they're all the same size and the full width, and then insert media. Now, clearly, you'd want to link this to a certain page. So this is where you would insert your link. And we don't need any description, so we can delete this all together. And now we can repeat the same steps with three other pages. So let's add About Us, Our Works, and Contact Us. So just like that, basically, as you can see, if I hover on top now, it will show a different background each and every time. Now let's take care of our font so it will stand out regardless of the background. So we go to style, and then let's select the normal mode and hover mode. So in normal mode, we're going to select a color transparent altogether, and we're going to add a stroke all around it. So let's select a white color. It should stand out properly, and a stroke of perhaps 1 pixel, just like this. As you can see, very nice. And let's do the same in hover mode, but this time the other way around. So this will be white. Now it looks absolutely fantastic. As you can see, if you hover on top, we have a very nice effect. And it's easy to read, and there's a beautiful contrast between the font and the background. And there you go. Our first template is ready. So let's click Update to save our changes. And now we can link this to our hamburger menu. So let's go back to this page. And remember, we had the template here. We left that blank. And we can now select our template. So here it is, hamburger template one. So let's click Update. And let's have a quick look. So let's have a preview. And now let's click on this. And there you go. As you can see, it's showing full width. Absolutely fantastic and beautiful. And if you hover on top, we have all these different images showing up in the background. And to exit our menu, all we have to do is to click on the X sign here, and we're back to our homepage. Very good. So let's go ahead with design number two now. So we go back to our WordPress dashboard. Again, we're going to use Elementor for this. As you can see, this is hamburger template one. So let's create hamburger template two. So let's add new. Again, this is a page. Let's give it a name. So let's call this one hamburger template two, and let's create our template. So again, we don't need any header and footer section. So we're going to go here in our settings and select canvas. And let's go ahead with our new section. So let's add a new section, one column. So for this section, we can keep all the settings the way they are, except for the height. We're going to set a minimum height of 100 and this is VH. So there you go. As you can see, now it's taking the full height of our page. Now let's set a background color. So we can add a gradient color this time. Why not? So let's go from a full black, so jet black, to maybe a darker gray, maybe something like this. Okay, so this is perfect. And now this is when it becomes very interesting. So we're going to add a new widget now, which is called Advanced Typography. You're going to love this one. So let's drag and drop this here. So this is a very comprehensive widget. Again, there are many, many different options. We're just going to use a few today just to show you how this works. So basically here, we're going to put our text. So let's call this one home. This would be our first link. So normally you would go to the advanced option here and you would insert the links on the URL to your page. And now let's add our on hover image reveal. So let's enable this. Let's select the same image we selected before. Insert media, and let's select the style. So this one will be style 3, but feel free to play around with this, you know. So let's click update and let's have a quick preview just to show you what it looks like in the front end. So let's click preview. So let's hover on top. And as you can see, as we do so, it will reveal the image. So you can apply different effects here again, you know, this is really up to you. So this is working fine. The only thing we need to do now is to change the color of the font, which is a bit too dark at the moment. So we go to style. And let's change the font color. So let's select white maybe. There you go. Now it stands out perfectly. And now we can do the same with the other three pages. So for this, we're going to add another widget, exactly the same. So we're going to look for advanced typography and we're going to do this three more times. Very good. So that's done now. So let's click update to save our changes. And now let's go to the front end and let's have a quick preview. And there you go. As you can see, now we have four different menu items. And if you hover on each one of them, it will reveal a different image. So that looks very trendy, very modern, absolutely amazing, doesn't it? And now we can link this to our hamburger menu. So let's go back to this section here. So let's click on this. And this time we're going to select for the template, hamburger template 2. Very good. So let's click update and let's have a quick preview. So let's click on this now. And there is our menu. And if you hover on top, we have all these different images. So that looks absolutely fantastic, doesn't it? And now if you wanted to just things up one step further, we can also add a custom cursor. So let's do this together. So let's go back to our page. And this time let's look for mouse cursor. So again, this is a widget from the Plus add-on. So let's drag and drop this on our page. And now we can configure our widget. So the cursor area here, we will select body. The type is going to be a follow circle. Now you can play around with those features. Obviously, it's a very comprehensive widget. Again, we'll have predefined here. Crosshair is fine. Body cursor as well. Now those settings are all the same. We're going to keep them exactly the way they are. And as you can see, this effect will be applied to a tag. So basically everything that's a hyperlink like this, it will show up. And now let's add our color. So we're going to add a color in normal mode and hover mode. So let's select a grayish color like this. And we're going to add a bit of transparency, just like that. And in hover mode, about the same color, but just clearer, a clearer background again, just like this, okay? Now we can update this. And now let's have a quick look in the front end. So let's click on this now. And as you can see, our menu is displaying fine. And we have that circle here, but it's not displaying properly. So if it happens to you, let me show you how to fix this very easily. So we go back here, we go to content, and you'll have to play around with the Z index. You might have to set it to -1. So let's click update. And let me show you the difference now. So we go back to our front end, we refresh our page. Let's click on our menu sections once more. Okay, so let's put this to the test. So if we hover on top, as you can see now, the circle is displaying behind the menu item. It is also displaying the small image by the side. So there you go, guys. This is how you can build and design beautiful full-width menu sections. So there you go, guys. This is how you can design a very modern full-width menu. Now we are open to your suggestions. And if your favorite feature is missing, then feel free to add it to our roadmap so that we can hear about your great ideas. And for this, simply go to roadmap.theplusaddons.com. And from there, you can submit your suggestions. And we'd like to thank you in advance for your help and support. Again, if you liked and learned something new in this video, then feel free to share with your friend, your Facebook communities, and make sure to hit the like and subscribe button so that YouTube knows that you loved this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.